Hi everyone, welcome to another video. This is Pascal Maynard recording for Channel Fireball, and today I'll be playing a Magic Online Vintage Cube or Holiday Cube 2012, as it's still called for some reason. For those who don't know, it's Cube Draft with Power 9 or powerful cards in it, basically. So very broken. I would say lots of non-interactive games, but sometimes it's fun. It's fun to just goldfish with a broken deck. So I don't play much cube at all in general. But since we're sort of in a downtime where we're in between like a set, the release of a set in the Pro Tour, there's no format I can play on Magic Online that's relevant. I wish I could show you some standard, but I can't play it on Magic Online. So decided to record some cubes, and here. So artifact mana are obviously really good. That's one thing I know. So Dakfaden is insane because it steals those, and there's a lot of powerful artifacts in the cube. I think I'm just gonna start with this. Also, blue red is just a really good color combination, I think. Cradle is very good. Friction Metamorph is probably pretty good. Crushing Relic is good. It's not one of the best mana artifact there is in this powered cube. I think in a regular cube it's much better. Tamiyo is reasonable planeswalker too. I'm just gonna take Dakfaden. Resize this thing. Alright, so we've got, so obviously Elspeth is pretty good. It's just a great planeswalker. But I think it would be a slam dunk in a regular cube. But since we're in a broken cube, I think I can do better. So what I like, I love Grixis combination in this kind of cube because it does a lot of broken things. And I think Entomb is really good in those because then I can play some sort of artifact team like Goblin Welder, return artifact into play, or just even creatures, because Dakfaden allows me to loot. So Entomb and Careful Study are both interesting. Boros Signet is pretty good. Well, it's just a mana rock, obviously. It's not great, but it's a mana rock. So I think I'm just gonna take Careful Study. I think it might be aggressive, and I should be taking something else. Like, the card's not really good on its own. It's just really good if I'm trying to combo. So this could be a wrong pick. Kidultha, Forge Master. Works well with artifact team if I can get a lot of artifacts. Snapcaster Mage is just very good on its own. Spellskites is okay. Force of Will is probably pretty good in this format, considering people are doing broken stuff. So card advantage is usually very necessary in a regular cube, but in this kind of cube, it's not as relevant. So I think I kind of want to take it, although Snapcaster is pretty good on its own. I think I'm going to force the combo route and take Force of Will here. Yeah, YOLO. It's probably wrong. Okay, so we can be Storm. Brain Freeze is the best Storm win condition. Because in a 40 card deck, milling your opponent is much easier. Steam Vents is something I would want to take. Chrome Mox and Animate Dead are all the cards I'm looking at. So we could decide to force Storm. Yeah, I think it's the time to jump in. Yeah, let's do this. Every time I try to force Storm, it's never got Brain Freeze. Now we got it, so let's try it. Okay, we got nothing for us here, unfortunately. I'm not sure if Kozilek is ever playable. Maybe. None of these cards would do to, I guess, Living Death, potentially, if we decide to be some sort of reanimator deck instead. I don't think Nykthos is going to work for playing a bunch of mana rocks. This thing works well with mana mana dork stuff. Like, just a creature makes a lot of mana, you can sort of combo with this. So I think I'm just going to take Living Death in case we get to that route. Inferno Titan is pretty good. Duplicate is pretty good if we're going to combo route. Corpse Dance, I don't like it as much as a reanimation spell. Tassigur is pretty good on its own. Terminate, if we end up Grixis, just a solid removal. I think I want to take Duplicate or Inferno Titan. And I believe I'll go with Duplicate. Basically, because it's an artifact, I think has a little bit more value. So Frantic Search, Bone Shredder. I don't think Smokestack's gonna do it. Godless Shrine. I believe Frantic Search. Works well with Reanimator and Storm. Okay, so we got, so the reanimating spells are there. Ultimate prize, solid removal. I think Lion's Eyes Diamond would probably be the best if we are Storm. Yeah, we just need to see the cards that works with it, such as like Yawgmoth's Will and stuff like that. Makeshift Mannequin works as a reanimation card. That or Pithing Needle. I think Makeshift Mannequin. None of those cards work. Kalidus, Elspeth. We're not going to play Wake for sure, so I think Kalidus or Elspeth. I'll go with Kalidus. Urborg. Maybe this is like a Storm thing? Probably not. Nah. Can't be enough instant sorceries. Just go with Urborg. Murderous Cut. Yeah, Murderous Cut's decent. Okay, Kozilek. Maloku, or I think I'll take Kozilek. Probably the thing that makes the most sense to reanimate. Oh, Terminate or Corpse Dance. With Terminate. I don't think Corpse Dance is that good. Oh, Bone Shredder's last pick is sweet. It's a decent card to play in a reanimate deck. Okay, so Demonic Tutor, Treachery is really good. It's probably one of, it's, I think it might just be singularly the best card in a regular cube. In this cube, it's probably still very good. Although we have Demonic Tutor in that pack. Mox Diamond. I don't think Mox Diamond is that good though. But Preordain, Demonic Tutor are very good. I would probably take Treachery over Preordain. But Demonic Tutor is just so important in Storm. I don't know, we have a lot of reanimator cards so far. We don't have anything very good to reanimate though. This is like okay to reanimate. It's not insane. So I think it's like my Storm cards are much better. Like Lead and Brain Freeze are really good. So I'm gonna go with Demonic Tutor. Dreddy, oh yeah, that was one of the cards I was thinking about when I took Dakfaden, and I thought I was telling you about the sort of artifact themed reanimate deck, because Dreddy is kind of a welder and it's pretty good in general, so I could take it. I have Duplicate so far. This doesn't really work super well with Lead though, and I don't have other artifacts. There's a Mirror Battlesphere in that pack, which is pretty good to reanimate. Thirst for Knowledge as well is very good in the deck. So it's Thirst, Temple of Deceit, Mirror Battlesphere, or Duretti. I think I'm going to go with Mirror Battlesphere and hope to wheel the Planeswalker. Because taking Duretti means I have to find some... I need to like wheel the Battlesphere or something. Whereas if I take the Battlesphere, I can still make Shvenkin or Living Death for it. Gifts Ungiven, Worn Power Stone. All right, I think we're gonna have to. We're not gonna be able to play Storm. Like we need to see Moxes and just a lot of good mana, like Ritual, and we're just not seeing it. So I don't think it's gonna work. So we'll have to be a reanimate deck. Gifts Ungiven. It's kind of medium, I think. Mindslaver is pretty good if we wield Duretti. But otherwise, it's not that good. Worn's Power Stone, maybe. Yeah, that might be wrong, but... Nicol Bolas. Temple. So you're not really red at all, except for Terminate and Deactivate, so that cut might be a splash. Mana Leak is decent. Yeah, Nicol Bolas is just not going to be cast if we don't have mana rocks. We can't reanimate it. So Mana Leak or the land. So if I move these here, that's 15 cards. I have no fixing. Yeah, I think I have to take this. I have Urborg as well. Dreadbore, Chandra, Angerback, Cabal Ritual. That would have been nice for Storm. It's not the worst in this deck either. I think getting Threshold is very real, and it might actually help us cast a big thing. So yeah, I'm just gonna take Cabal Ritual. So Temple, Top Duress, maybe Signet. I think Temple. Top is just not insane by any means. And Scrylands are very good in combo decks, so definitely enjoy those. Liliana's nice. Through the Breach is nice. Empty the Warrens is nice. So we're seeing the Storm enablers. We're seeing the Storm kill conditions. We're not seeing the mana, basically. We're so close. Liliana is pretty good in Reanimator. I didn't wheel Necromancy or Animate Dead, so I'm kind of scared that I might not see anything else. Woodfall Primus is good to reanimate. I think I'm just going to take Liliana and hope I see other cards to reanimate. Dart Ritual is great. It's not as good, we're not playing combo. Young Pyromancer is pretty good on its own. Reflowing Chalice, decent. Almost the same as a regular Signet, I guess. Kind of want to take the Dark Ritual here and hope to wield the Emptied Orins and then go back to combo. But then... yeah, let's go. Let's hope it works. All right, Mux Diamond. Terastodon, I guess. Tadadel. Or Gurmag Angler, maybe. I guess Tadadel. This shuffles. Pretend it's shuffle, so I can't really play it. I'll just make a bull ass. Dreadbore. Maybe I'll play it. Probably, actually. Duress, cool. Yeah, so we didn't wheel Amphitorins. So I think that's just... Oh! Yeah, I guess we did. It was the last card. Nice. Okay, so can we do it now? I think we need to see some really powerful Storm cards for it to work at this point. I don't think we're going to play that. Okay, Bezar is decent in Reanimate. Ponder is good in Storm. I guess there's only Scalding Tarn that's really good in as another option, and we don't have duels, so it's like probably one of the worst duels we can get. Worst type of duel. I think I'll go with Ponder. It's just going to be good in whatever I decide to play. Obviously, I'm concerned that Force of Will might not be good enough. Grizzlebrand is great. But Manavolt is very good, too. I need some sort of draw 7. I just don't have it. Yeah, we need a lot of pieces to make Storm work. I can take Manavolt, which is going to be good either way. I think Gilidus is going to be pretty medium, no matter what we're playing. So I can take Manavolt and just hope we see a draw 7. Otherwise, would I take Grizzlebrand? I'm not even sure. I guess Grizzlebrand, I can still cast. Grizzlebrand is sort of a draw 7 that I can sort of cast too. I'll just take it. Cast it as a Yagmoth's Bargain. Grim Tutor is decent. I don't really need. I have enough tutors and draw and single draw spells at this point. I don't really need a card like Grim Tutor. Magus of the Wheel. I don't know what that card is. Oh, it's probably from Commander or something. Sacrifice for a draw. Oh, and draw. So that's a draw 7. However, it's vulnerable to removal, of course. So I think Dig True Time is a better sort of good draw spell to get True Time. Mind's Desire, sweet. That's a good one. Yeah, I'll take it. All right, so we can flush some of those. Okay, can I play Cryptic in my deck? Brain Maggot is okay. Exhume is a reanimate spell. Sort of a good one. I don't think I can ever cast Cryptic Command. I'll take Exhume. I'm in between Storm and Reanimate. It's weird. Dark Petition is great. But I don't need that kind of tutors. So either Baleful's Tricks, or I think I might have to take Signet. Yeah, I'm going to have to take Signet here. A land. Oh, Time Twister. There we go. Yep, there we go. Seething Song. Can I play that? It's not even that good because making 5 red mana is just... super medium. So all these go back in, just gone, 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 probably gone. So I take off color signet or seating song. Signet. Ugh. Not sure. That might be wrong. Eh, probably wrong, actually. I just feel like it's going to be hard to use the red mana. I guess I have Mind's Desire and Dig Through Time. So I kept these. I kept Kozilek and Grizzlebrand in there because it might be useful as just like Ardcast and draw a bunch. Okay, so that's a pack we wheel. There's nothing I want to play. I'll just take Diabolic Edict. Painful Truth. Painful Truth is pretty good, I think. Yeah, it's definitely great. I didn't even notice I didn't even consider it when I saw it earlier. Maybe I should have. But we wheeled it. Yeah, I'm definitely missing like Mux or Black Lotus. I guess I have Lionsize Diamond. So Grim Tutor or Tar Pit. Tar Pit is straight up a man land, a dual land. Like I'm never gonna activate it. I think it might still be good enough. Grim Tutor. I don't think Grim Tutor is very good. Try to have like a bad dual land. We don't play Bone Shredder. We don't play Kozilek. Definitely don't play Living Death. Yeah, this deck might work. It's definitely not going to be easy to play. It's going to be enjoyable for you. And I cannot wait to read all the comments that tell me the hundreds and hundreds of mistakes I'm gonna make in those games. That's kind of interesting with Grizzlebrand. Shallowgrave, but it's hard to dump it in a graveyard. It's probably too narrow. Guess maybe Signet. Not impossible that I just played a Signet. I don't have like enough instant mana cards like rituals and stuff, so I might have to just play a bunch of signets and then go off when I have enough mana. Don't know if I'm gonna regret that seeding song. We have three great storm. I guess Emptedorans is bad. It's probably one of the worst. I wish I had like Tendrils instead. Brain Maggot's decent. Sideboard card, I guess. Yeah, I wish I had Tendrils instead of Emptied Orins, obviously. I'm not even sure if I'm playing red. Well, I guess I have two duels and like a Signet and some amount of card draw. Oh, Dark Petition. Sweet. Probably play it. Faithless Looting? Wow. Alright, we got pretty lucky in the cards we got passed, I guess. I don't know if I'm going to play with Faithless Looting. Probably not, because I'm like splashing red. It's funny because my deck can easily sideboard into a reanimator deck. I don't know what matchup I want to do this. but I can do it if I want. So if Faithless Doing doesn't make the cut, yeah, that definitely doesn't, I don't think. That's decent with like Lion's Eyes Diamond. No, I guess it's not. No, it dumps my hand. Yeah, it doesn't really do anything. Yeah, like I have to play Lion's Eyes Diamond. I have, so it works sort of well with Dig True Time, Dark Petition, and Time Twister. And I have Demonic Tutor to find Time Twister. Alright, deck building. I think we're not playing Terminate. Just don't really need that kind of interaction. So can I reasonably cast this Grizzlebrand or not? It's a lot of mana. I kind of have to pass the turn once I play it, which is not ideal. Probably play all these signets. Two of those signets are black, which makes casting Grizzlebrand actually a thing. I have Urborg too. So if I play this configuration, I would play 16 lands plus all of these. I don't know if that's too much. I don't think that's too much because if I had Muxes and stuff, sure, but like I have Mux Diamond, which requires to have more lands in my deck. I have a couple ways to loot. So having too many lands, I just need to make my land drops until I can have enough mana to go off. So yeah, I'm going to play this in 16 lands, I believe. Maybe playing this Grizzlebrand is just a total mistake. But I think it's reasonable that I cast it. And I can always just dump it in Careful Study, Frantic Search, or Dak Faden. Force of Will might be a huge mistake. I have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have 8 blue cards. It's not horrible. However, I just feel like it's gonna be really hard for me if I dump a blue card just be able to go off. All these blue cards are cards I probably will want to cast. I could see like Study or Frantic Search as a card that I don't really want to cast, or Dak Faden. Yeah, I'll keep it as safety. Like I have no cards at all to defend myself except Duress. Because I have a Murderous Cut. Yeah, is Murderous Cut just worse than Terminate my deck? No, probably not because it's on the splash. I didn't have nothing to play with my graveyard, which means, oh, it's not true. Actually, I have one Delve spell, and I have a Spell Mastery thing. It's not. It could be an issue. Maybe I just don't play it, and only board it in if I play against something that's scary. Faithless Looting is tempting, just as another like cheap spell. Cheap spells are just really good with Storm, obviously. Yeah, I'll probably play Faithless Looting. I have a lot of loot. Could be just wrong. Too much looting is definitely a problem. Because I will not want to play them early game. Because I need to develop resources, and then I guess later it's good because of Storm. That's the reason I want to play it. But I also have nothing to play with the graveyard except Dig Through Time and Dark Petition. But I guess those two are pretty important. Yeah, sure, I'll play Faithless Looting. All in, no removal. Let's do this. And at this point, playing playing one reanimate spell sort of makes sense because I have so much looting that I can just dump this Grizzlebrand and bring it back. I wish I had taken Shalagrave. My other option is Exhume. So I could play like one Exhume. I'll make my mana base, see what it looks like. So, black, this is black, this is blue, sort of, because I'm not playing a lot of red. So, two mountain, does that make any sense? I have one red signet, that would be a total of five red sources plus my card draw. Yeah, that sounds good. I could even cut one, probably. I have Mux Diamond as well. Yeah, I guess it depends if I played a Fateless Looting or not. Swamp, so 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, 8 is enough, for sure. I have 2 Black Signets as well. And I don't really have black spells that I want to play early. So I could even cut one. And then blue, 5, 6, 7. I have one signet, but I have Ponder and Careful Study and Frantic Search. And I have double blue. Yeah, I think I'll probably want like 8 total. So it's 39 and 15 lands. I for sure want 16 lands, I believe. Definitely add a swamp if something. Yeah, I'll add a swamp. This may be a mountain if I do play it, if it's looting or not. Yeah, the problem is adding this Fateless Looting. Then I kind of want to play it Exhumed, but then I have to cut a card. So either a Signet or Worn Power Stone. I'll cut a swamp, play a mountain, and play the Fateless Looting. Alright, we'll try this. Definitely gonna have to play with the deck open to my left in another screen, because piloting this is not gonna be easy. I'll see you in matches. Yeah.